pursed your lips, glossed them over with the rouge lipstick you were once envious your mother always wore, paired with the pearl earrings. Slink into the black cocktail dress that shows the perfect amount of boudoir meets the elegance of the roaring 20s cleavage, even though you would prefer a fuck me daddy top, draped with a candy-colored faux fur scarf, and the lowest of plain black slim-fit pants. Spritz Chanel No. 5 over the top of your pulse points, even though the aldehydic cat piss meets vinegar stench makes your stomach churn, whichever beach body bullshit diet food you have challenged yourself to keep accountable for, to please and to impress the most Neanderthal of three pump chump men you have tallied throughout the past few college fling years, even though you would rather mouthfuck that pepperoni pizza slathered in grease from the local authentic pie shop till your eyes roll into the back of your skull and the grease pools collectively into the crotch of your now uncomfortably tight black jeans. Curl your hair until it's fried like a death row inmate up on the chopping block. Primp and poke and paint your face until you are no longer recognizable. Cram your feet into a size too small pair of wedges, since the only curling your toes will be experiencing will come from the tight shoes, not the easily distracted know-nothing boy you will inevitably go home with that can't find his way around a quit to save his fucking mama's boy life. Rinse and repeat. This is a collective concoction of ingredients to make it through a typical Friday night of being a mannequin for femininity. Always pretending. Pretending to enjoy social events crowded with nobodies, sprinkled with a few friends you like. Pretending to feel grateful for the compliments received from the mentally deficient, barely obtained a high school diploma, backwards hat wearing douchebags that take an hour to muster up the courage to approach you, and a tenth of that time to climax. Pretending to come to. Pretending to want to do it all again the following weekend. Cinnamon dolce.
How perfect. Flavored coffee male voice. How masculine of you. I take mine black.
Mask it all with the latest Balenciaga trends. Shots of tequila and cigarettes. Mask the charade with another charade. And mix and match until everyone is expected to function the very same way in complete and utter robotic mediocrity.
Trim the fat.
Cut
the sugar.
Sweat longer and spend bigger. Starve more.
Enjoy less.
Innocence is like a cigarette burn on the underbelly of a tattered barber chair you grew through phases of your life, planting your ass in. It holds a certain nostalgic nuance, but sooner or later, once you find the blemish, you pick at it until it flakes and tears, more and more until it's tossed to the curb with the rest of childhood novelties. Also, why can't I wear floral fragrance if I want? Marketing is weird. I like the smell of daisies. Why can I smell like a fucking bundle of daisies if I would like? Why do I have to smell like rugged leather that's been saturated with week-old ball sweat to be masculine? You know what? I don't accept it. I'm going out today smelling like a goddamn bundle of joy, not a bag of beef jerky and belly button lint. I don't get it. I really do not get it. I am deep. I'm a dude, but I have all these thoughts and feelings and ideas and no one to share them with. Like, I want to write sonnets and paint, and I want to dress fashionable. And I want to fucking eat something other than steak. I goddamn love buffalo chicken salad. My balls itch. I fucking hate how there's no winning with a leather couch. It's either freezing or slippery. You're hot as hell and your balls are sticking to the goddamn thing and you have to peel yourself off like a fucking band-aid and it's just unfair. Like, what if I want to wear makeup and a bra? Who made these rules? I am just tired of it. I like art and literature and kittens, and I want to talk about real shit. Not pretend everything is okay with the cookie cutter bowl like, oh hey Joe, how's the fucking weather? I know your 7-year-old is currently in ICU and could pass at any second, but goddamn tell me about those nimbus clouds. Will they finally part and shine some fucking light on life?
I am a woman. I'm a goddamn flippin' damn fucking woman. I don't want to be delicately made love to. I want to be fucked. I want raw, real lust. I want love. I want someone like me who wants these things and could pursue wanting with me. What is that smell?
I need someone who values individuality. I want it. God help me, I'll blow my fucking brains out here and now.
If I can't have it! Huh?